is your enabler.
Jesus.
That comes with making God your hope in hell. It got to be the word in there. That ignites your thankfulness. You can't do this on your own. You need God's word, because the word is going to tell you what to do. It's going to tell you what not to do. It's going to make you understand this is why that's happening to you. Oh God, my son got locked up in jail. What do you need to do right by God? I got two of them. One sitting back there in the back. And I got another I'm praying for. I don't know how God will move in their lives. But we God move good around the shackles of the success in giving yourselves away to God. Your spiritual progression, say with me, my spiritual progression,
will stop when I stop.
See, this is what we don't understand. We have to maintain. You don't stop brushing your teeth. Stop brushing your teeth. Okay, some people do. Okay, well, stop brushing your teeth then. Stop combing your hair. Just stop taking care of yourself. Don't even wash your face no more. You will be a mess waiting to pollute everything you come in contact with. There must be a maintaining your spiritual relationship with God. You got to pray every day, praise every day, read the word every day, love on God every day. Show your thankfulness by being grateful. Release mercy and grace to other people that you got to deal with. That's treat right. People like you want to be treated.
Amen.
You don't want nobody talking about you stepping all over you. Put your name on the highlight on the gossip about other folks.
Amen.
Pray for them. These seven things are vital. Maintenance is vital. You cannot take it lightly. Maintenance is necessary. You got to allow your soul to be under the entrapment of the word. Anybody seen the movie Entrapment? You got to allow your soul to be up under the snare of the word. Meaning the word has caught your soul. It captured you. And it captured you so much that you are a slave to it. Now, since you are a slave, then you just what got to do it. You got to get militant in your pursuit. Sometimes God get involved with initiating and purging his children, just like I was talking about my son. So you don't want to give yourself to God? And somebody praying, they've been praying, and the prayers went up, and the prayers of the righteous availed much. Okay. Let's see. Let God purge you. Let God get you. He know how to get you. You don't want to give yourself to God? Okay. Alright. Let God do it. You can initiate it yourself. The Bible says when you judge yourself, when you choose to get into the word and allow the word to wash you, you'll not come under the judgment of God. God initiates a thing by letting things happen to you. You might not like how God do it. I'm going to go ahead and give myself to God and stop letting things in my soul ties infect, influence me. Glory to God. Deuteronomy 28:15 says, just to close out this part of our subtopic and then we'll move to another topic. But if you refuse to listen to the Lord, Deuteronomy 28:15, and give yourself to God with those seven instructions that he gave, and you do not obey all the commandments and decrees that I've given you today, all these curses will come and overwhelm you. When God tells us to participate in the cleansing of ourselves of sin, we must, else we maintain the status quo of the sinful nature. To maintain the status quo of something, meaning you maintain the condition of it. Meaning you feed that thing, you giving it what it needs to stay. When you refuse to give yourself to God, by exercising your spiritual story, by default, you maintain the status quo of the sinful nature. You do that on your own. To whatever you give attention to is the result of your will to choose your heart. You're getting what you put in. Whatever you gave, you did that. If you don't on purpose give yourself to God, you automatically give yourself to the sin, those three things, the world, and the devil. It's a curse not to experience God's happiness.
Right.
When God created Adam and Eve, he said them it's good. He gave them everything they need. It's a curse to live outside of what God has already released concerning mankind.
Mm-hmm.
Happiness, peace, joy, wholeness that God has chosen to give to every man.
Mm-hmm.
Yet every man, as an act of his own choosing, has the ability to choose the day who he going to serve.
Yes.
Say with me, I choose who I'm going to serve.
I choose who I'm going to serve.
And who I give myself to.
And who I give myself to.
Uh-oh. The moment you understand that, you become accountable.
Right. That's right.
I didn't mean to lead you into that. God has told me to say it.
That's right.
You're trying to reap what you sow. You sow that, so you reap it.
Yes.
Rather, he chooses to serve himself, those three, the devil or the world, money, food, material gain.
Mm.
It all happens by choice. Nothing comes by chance.
Right.
And I heard God say that in my studies.
Say that.
They chose that.
Nothing come by chance.
They chose that.
Huh.
Especially when you've heard the word.
The word. That's
and you
right.
know the truth.
That's right.
Somebody had a direct part as to why that took place.
Mm-hmm.
So investigation. The Bible says examine your own self.
Mm-hmm.
See why you did that. See if you in the faith or you in yourself. This is what God wants us to do on a daily basis. All this is what we've been teaching, along with these seven things that cause by way of maintenance. Stand to your feet. Just as Abram offered his son to God, by presenting his son before the altar, this is what God wants you to do on a daily basis. Every day there's a giving up, a surrendering. There's an offering that you must be willing to participate in. Lord God, hallelujah. Thank you. Hallelujah. Oh, my God. Hallelujah. Every day you have breath in your body, there's an opportunity to give yourself away. Will you say yes to Him? Will you allow your soul to ring out loud and unending yes to God? Hallelujah. Just as we as men can say yes to so many other things, we got to know that we have the gift to say yes to God. It is sincerely a gift to be able to choose and understand your choosing. It's an outright curse to not be able to give yourself to a God that created you.